Write down the next problem. Calculate the breakdown power of breakdown power of an air filled coaxial cable coaxial cable operating coaxial cable operating the coaxial cable operating at frequency of gigahertz. Assume a ratio of B by A. is equals to 2.3 and B plus A less than lambda by pi. To exclude higher order modes, to exclude higher order modes and a dominant mode. Propagating. This is the question. Calculate the breakdown power of an air-filled coaxial cable operating at frequency of 9.375 gigahertz. Assume a ratio of B by A is equals to 2.3 and B plus A is less than lambda by pi. To exclude higher order modes and a dominant mode propagating. Solution. What is the solution? You need to calculate the breakdown power. Breakdown power and air filled coaxial cable. Fine. So the power the power at breakdown condition, B suffix D need to represent like this, of a coaxial cable given by P suffix BD P suffix BD of TMO, TMO is equals to 3600 A square logarithmic of B by A in terms of kilowatts. What is the A value? You don't know, right? You don't know the A value. So if you want to find out A value, means first you need to find out lambda. You need to find out lambda value. So lambda is nothing but what? Wavelength. Wavelength of the coaxial cable. So wavelength lambda. Wavelength lambda naught is equals to C divided by F. C divided by F. Tell me, C means 3 × 10⁸. F means 9.5 from the problem. 375 gigahertz means 10 to kilo means 3, giga means this is a 9, right? Next. Now what is the answer? Tell me the answer for this. 3.32 centimeters. Lambda naught is equals to 3.2 centimeters. Wavelength of the coaxial cable. Okay, now you are getting the lambda naught value. That value you are getting. After that, first you need to write down B by A is from the problem. B by A is 2.3. And what about A, B plus A? And B plus A is less than lambda by pi. Yes or no? You know the lambda value. And you know the pi value. Substitute that value. Now what is the answer? Tell me. You will have both values. From this you need to find out the A value. Okay now. How to find out? First you need to find out B plus A. This value is less than or equal to lambda by pi. So by using this you need to find out A. A is equals to, we will get it like 2.42 centimeters. Okay, after getting A value, then you need to find out B value. What is the B value? A value 2.42. I think this B by A value you have already 2:3. Substitute that value in that. It's 3600. A square means 2.42 centimeters, means you need to convert that into meters, or else you need to like same. Logarithmic of B by A means 2.3. What is the answer you need to tell me? 398 kilowatts. Breakdown. If you want to find out breakdown coaxial cable breakdown power, means first you need to find out wavelength value lambda naught C by F with the help of the formula C by F. C means you know it, 3 × 10⁸. F means 9.375 × 10⁹. Adjust. Simplify the expression, you will get lambda naught is equals to 3.2 centimeters. From the problem we have B plus A is less than lambda by pi and B by A is 2.3. Okay, from these two you will get it, A is equals to 2.42 centimeters. Apply mathematical formula here. B minus A is equals to, you need to apply that formula, then you will get it the, here you have A plus B, A minus B, then you will get it the A and B values. After that only you will get the A is equals to 2.42 centimeters. Substitute this A value in the equation, in the equation 1. Okay, A is 2.42, substitute in that, and you know the B by A value 2.3. Substitute both two values. Simplify the expression. P suffix BD is equals to 398 kilowatts. We will get the power. break down power of a air fuel coaxial cable. Okay. Write our next problem. A strip line transmission line has a distance of 0.3175 centimeters between the ground planes, Full stop. If the diameter of the equivalent circular conductor, if the diameter of the equivalent circular conductor is 0.0539 centimeters. Full stop. Determine the characteristic impedance and velocity of propagation. If the dielectric constant is 2.32 for the strip line material. This is the question. A strip line transmission line has distance of 0.3175 centimeter between a ground planes. If the diameter of the equivalent circular conductor is 0.0539 centimeters, determine the characteristic impedance and velocity of the propagation. If the dielectric constant is 2.32 for the strip line material, first you need to write down given data. For any problem, first you need to write down given data, given that what we have from the B value is equals to distance of strip line transmission line has the distance is B is equals to, let us assume the distance is B is equals to 0.3175 centimeter. Then next parameter is circular conductor diameter d is equals to d is equals to 0.0539 centimeter. Next, last one. What we have? Dielectric constant epsilon r. Epsilon r is equals to 2.32. What do you need to find out first? Characteristic impedance. Characteristic impedance first you need to find out. Characteristic impedance. First one is characteristics impedance. Impedance is equals to Z naught. Characteristic impedance Z naught is equals to 60. Z naught is equals to 60 divided by square root epsilon r into logarithmic of capital 4b divided by pi d. Substitute the values. 60 divided by epsilon r means 2.32. Logarithmic of 4 into b means 0.3175 divided by pi means, you know it, 3.00539. What is the answer? 79.38 ohms. The first one is characteristic impedance Z0. The second one, what is the second one? Second one is velocity of the propagation. V is equals to C divided by square root epsilon r. C divided by square root epsilon r. Substitute the values. We have C value 3 into 10 to the power of 8. Then square root epsilon r is 2.32. Simplify the expression. What you will get it? The answer is 1.97 into 10 to the power of 8 meters per second. Like that, you need to find out the solution for any strip line transmission line. Right, from this problem, we have distance B 0.3175 centimeters. And we have diameter of the circular conductor d is equal to 0.0539 centimeters, and we have the dielectric constant is 2.32. Okay, so from that we need to find out characteristic impedance Z0 is equal to 60 divided by square root epsilon r into logarithmic of 4b divided by pi d. You know the epsilon r value 2.32. B value is equals to 0.3175 centimeter and D value 0.0539 centimeter. Substitute all these values in this equation. You will get the answer Z0 is equals to 79.38 ohms. After that, you need to find out velocity of propagation. V is equals to C divided by square root epsilon r. C is equals to 3 into 10 to the power of 8. You need to substitute that here, and epsilon r value 2.32. After doing some simplifications, after some calculations, we will get the 1.97 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second is the velocity of the propagation. Like that, you need to find out the answer for any problem.